For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a higher-end motherboard from ASUS that sports the brand new Intel Z890 chipset, the ASUS ROG Strix Z890-F Gaming Wi-Fi. Sporting support for Intel's latest Arrow Lake S Core Ultra 200S series of desktop processors, we'll be taking a closer look at the specs of this board to see if it's any good. Let's get started. In case you missed the news, Intel will be releasing its latest Arrow Lake S Core Ultra 200S series of processors for sale to the public on 24th October 2024, which is in a couple of days' time, alongside motherboards powered by the new Intel Z890 chipset. To get in on the launch excitement, we'll be taking a look at the ASUS ROG Strix Z890-F Gaming Wi-Fi that, as its name implies, sports the Z890 chipset and sits within the performance-oriented ROG Strix series of gaming motherboard offerings, where it places below the range-topping ROG Maxima series and sits above the mainstream tough gaming lineup, as well as the budget-friendly Prime series of motherboard offerings by ASUS. As an offering from the Republic of Gamers lineup, no surprises here that ASUS has gone for the usual black and red colorway that's associated with the ROG brand for the motherboard box. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's have a look at the contents of the box. We see that the Z890-F Gaming Wi-Fi comes with a Wi-Fi antenna right here. Now let's set aside the board for the moment to see what other accessories ASUS has included with the board. First up, we get a quick start guide right here. And this is accompanied by an ASUS Web Storage promotional offer leaflet. We do also get a sheet of ROG stickers, as well as a packet of accessories. Within the accessories pack, we get two SATA 3 cables. And these are accompanied by 3 packs of M.2 drive rubber pads that are used to add additional height clearance for single-sided M.2 drives. We do also get a M.2 Q-latch attachment right here, as well as a pack of cable ties. We do also get an extension thermal pad for folks intending to install a M.2 SSD in the 22110 form factor, as well as a ROG keychain. Onto the board itself, we see that ASUS has gone for a predominantly black aesthetic with plenty of ROG motifs and marketing text thrown in for good measure. As can be seen, the board comes with an integrated I/O shield design and large black heat sinks all around. Over on the rear of the board, we get a slew of ROG motifs as well that, I suppose, are a nice touch in spite of the fact that most of these motifs would likely never see the light of day when the board is installed inside of a PC case. That aside, RGB junkies will be pleased to note that the board comes with the polymer lighting feature on the integrated I/O shield shroud, which I have to say looks pretty nice in my opinion. In terms of heatsink coverage, the Z890 chipset is cooled by a large passive heatsink, and we do also get full heatsink coverage for all 5 of the board's M.2 slots. The VRM heatsinks for this board are sizable, and ASUS has included 16+1+2+2 power stages, with VCC core stages rated for a whopping 110 amps each. For memory support, the ROG Strix Z890-F Gaming Wi-Fi comes with 4 DDR5 slots that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 192GB of RAM and the DDR5 8600 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tab design. Naturally, the board also supports Intel's XMP technology, which are basically built-in overclocking profiles for DDR5 memory. It's great to note too that the board also supports the latest DIMM format on the block, clocked unbuffered DIMMs, which come with a clock driver on the memory module so as to improve signal stability, thereby paving the way for even higher operating frequencies. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 20Gbps Type-C front panel header right next to the RAM slots, and beneath it, two USB 5Gbps front panel headers that each provide support for up to two USB 5Gbps Type-A ports, for a total of four ports. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Some interesting features to highlight. Back at the top of the board, we get a CPU overvoltage jumper that enables higher CPU voltages for overclocking purposes, a set of QLEDs that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues, as well as a start button that allows you to power on the PC. Over on the bottom edge of the board, we get a Thunderbolt header that is to be used with an optional ASUS Thunderbolt add-on card for more Thunderbolt ports, a thermal sensor header that allows you to connect an optional thermistor cable so as to monitor the temperature of devices within your PC case, as well as a chassis intrusion header. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0 x16 slot that sports the ASUS Safe Slot feature that reinforces the slot for use with heavy graphics cards. The said slot also has the new PCIe Slot Q-Release Slim feature that makes removing a graphics card an even simpler affair. There is no need to release a latch or even push down on a button anymore. All you have to do is pull the card out at a certain angle towards the latch mechanism and it will come free. We do also get a full-length PCIe 4.0 x16 slot that operates at X4 mode. In the storage department, ASUS has included four SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. For M.2 slots, it comes with a single PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slot and four PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots. Do note that the first four slots support M.2 NVMe drives only, while the last slot pictured here supports either a M.2 NVMe or a M.2 SATA drive. That's it. The PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slot comes with a pretty fancy heatsink and features the M.2 Q-release mechanism, where pushing down on this metal latch right here will release the heatsink. I must say, the heatsink feels pretty premium. The Gen 5 M.2 slot also features a new quality of life feature called Q-Slide, which is a mechanism that slides along a track and snaps into place so as to securely hold an M.2 device of varying lengths. That said, all of the board's M.2 slots do also feature an improved Q-latch mechanism, which makes installing and removing a M.2 drive a breeze, like so. For audio, ASUS has included a high-end Realtek ALC4080 audio codec with premium audio capacitors, as well as a Savitech SV3H712 amplifier chip. Wired internet connectivity is courtesy of Intel's i226V chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi support is courtesy of an Intel BE200NGW Wi-Fi 7 part that supports the 320 MHz channel width and also serves up Bluetooth 5.4 support. Intercooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 8 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 Gen 2 addressable RGB headers located in these regions. Moving over to the rear I/O, the ROG Strix Z890-F gaming Wi-Fi goes for an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector that supports display output of up to 8K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a clear CMOS button, a BIOS flashback button that allows end users to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card, 4 USB 5Gbps Type-A ports, 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, 4 USB 10Gbps Type-A ports, with this port here supporting the BIOS flashback feature, 2 Thunderbolt 4 USB Type-C ports that support DisplayPort and Thunderbolt video output. On the Thunderbolt display mode, the board supports up to the 8K resolution at 60Hz for a single display via 1 Thunderbolt 4 port, or 2 displays via 2 Thunderbolt 4 ports at a maximum resolution of 4K at 60Hz each. Moving on, we do also get 2 USB 10Gbps Type-C ports, with this port here supporting up to 30 watts of power delivery for fast charging, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new Q antenna connectors, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. To sum up, the ASUS ROG Strix Z890-F Gaming Wi-Fi is a high-end Intel Z890 motherboard with plenty of bells and whistles to satisfy the needs of PC hardware enthusiasts without going too overboard in terms of the feature list. It comes with a pretty solid VRM setup with 110 amp power phases, PCIe 5.0 support for both a graphics card and an M.2 drive, plenty of M.2 drive slots without any bifurcation shenanigans, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet with built-in Wi-Fi 7, dual Thunderbolt 4 ports, and a plethora of USB Type-C and Type-A connectivity options, along with lots of new quality of life features such as Q-Release Slim, Q-Slide, and so on. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.